Hi. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the Box-Jenkins approach of building time series model. So this is one of the standard approach used in time series analysis. So two statisticians, Box and Jenkins, they provided some standard approach of building ARMA model, which is also used in other kind of types of time series models like ARIMA. Okay. So we'll learn about ARIMA model in a separate video. So their approach consists of three different steps. In the first step, it's an identification step where you identify the model type and you some sort of specify the time series model. In the second step, you estimate the model, and in the third step, you do the diagnostic checking if the model is correct or not. Okay, so there are three steps to the modeling process. So we'll discuss the different steps in more detail. The first step, what you do is you determine the order of the model. Okay, let's say we are trying to build an ARMA model. So we've got two parameters here, right? P and Q, right? The AR component and the MA component. Okay, so what are the orders, or what are the orders of the these components AR and MA? Okay, so in the first step, what we'll do, or what one is supposed to do, is to plot the ACF and the PACF to find out the P and Q. In the previous videos, we learned about how to determine the P and Q value, the order of the time series models, by looking at the ACF and PACF plots, right? There are better ways of doing it also. So in one of the video later on, we'll also see some additional way, or some different way of determining the P and Q values, right? The optimum or the correct P and Q values. PACF and ACF are of course very good way of determining, but there are also additional ways of doing that. Okay, so in the first step, all you do is find out what is the P and Q value, right? All right, in the second step, you do the estimation. Now that it is very clear that, okay, how many lags are to be used for YT and for the residual term UT, right? So you got to find out the parameters. So let's say the example yt equal to phi 1 yt minus 1 and theta 1 ut minus 1 plus ut. So this is a ARMA 1-1 model, right? This is a ARMA 1-1 model. Okay, so the AR term has 1 lag, and then the MA term has also 1 lag, right? So this is a ARMA 1-1 model, and it is very clear that the AR component has only 1 lag and the MA component has also 1 lag. So using one of the estimation technique, like it could be ordinary least square, or it could be maximum likelihood, okay, you can find out the values of phis and thetas, right? And and when you find that, which you will find some numbers, then the model will be complete, or it is going to be a full-fledged time series model, and then you will see in the next step whether this is a correct specification or not. And that's the third step. In third step, we would check if the model fit is good. Okay, remember the term here, the model fit, right? Pretty much like any other statistical model, once you have found out the estimates, the values of the estimates, you will be checking if the model is fitting the data properly or not. So there could be two problems with this. One is overfitting, or it could be underfitting. Okay, so overfitting is a typical problem where you are adding like more terms to the model, or you are sort of you're not generalizing the pattern in the data. You are simply the model will work fine with the available data with you, but it's not going to work fine in the future data or in the new data that for which you will be using the model later on. So that is a typical case of overfitting. Like it is very specific to the data that you are using for the model building. So it is the training data that you are using is fitting very well, but when you use it for test data, that means a new data, totally new data, it's going to perform badly, right? So that's the case of typical overfitting case, which is pretty much the same in any statistical model. The other one is the underfitting. That means you are not properly specifying or you are not able to capture the pattern in the data, and that will result in a problem known as the autocorrelation of the error. Okay, autocorrelation of error terms. Okay, hence, so as part of diagnostic check, you should also do the residual diagnostic check. Right, once you have you know, estimated your parameters, so there are two things to be seen. One is whether the model is overfitting, and the second one is whether the residuals are having or showing some sort of a correlation among themselves. Okay, so how do you see for overfitting? Well, you take you use that model for different test data and see whether they are actually you know, fitting really well, pretty much the, like the training data or the data for which you are building the model. So you use, it could also you could also use the simulations to find out whether the data is fitting very well or it's not. So that one way of, you know, test checking for overfitting. For the residual diagnostics, there are some statistical tests. We'll talk about it in while we use the Box-Jenkins procedure or approach of doing models using some sort of statistical technique. So there are some statistical techniques available to check the residual diagnostics, and based on you know, the hypothesis used in for the statistical test, you will be able to know whether there is a presence of autocorrelation in the residual terms or not. So these are the three different steps of a Box-Jenkins approach. We'll use these three steps in a separate video in this series, wherein we'll take an example and we'll use these three steps to build a time series model or ARMA model in particular. Thank you, and please subscribe to our channel and also visit our website.